In this video, I'm going to talk about some of the features of Virtualmin, show you how to create a new website, and how to install a WordPress blog using the install scripts feature. So what is Virtualmin? Virtualmin is a web hosting control panel for Linux and Unix systems. It's pretty popular with over 100,000 installations worldwide. It's available in a free and open source version called Virtualmin GPL, and a commercial version called Virtualmin Professional. I'll talk briefly about some of the differences between the two versions later in the video, and you can check out the links below for more complete details about that. A web hosting control panel is a tool that makes managing websites easier and faster than doing it manually. It also allows delegation of common tasks to less privileged users in a safer way than allowing them directly modify configuration files. Virtualmin is based on Webmin, and it manages the Apache or Nginx web server, MySQL, Postgres, Oracle, and SQLite databases, PostFix, SendMail, or QMail web servers, Dovecot, IMAP and POP server, the Bind DNS server, and it does mail filtering with Spam Assassin and ClamAV, and a whole lot of other things. In this video, we'll create a website with a domain name, databases, email, and a blogging application. Future videos will go into more detail about how to get the most out of Virtualmin. First, I want to introduce you to the user face of Virtualmin. When you log into Virtualmin as root or the administrative user of the system, you'll see something like this. Many of the elements you see, like color scheme, is customizable. The page on the right is the system information dashboard. Here you'll see a summary of important information about your Virtualmin web hosting system. This includes the current CPU usage, real memory, virtual memory, or the swap memory, and local disk space usage. It also includes the host name, the operating system and version, and a variety of other information about the installation of Virtualmin, like the Webmin version, the theme version, stuff about the system itself. And the menu on the left provides instant access to the most commonly used functions of Virtualmin and Webmin. For this video, I'll show you how to create a new website account and install a web application so you can see how simple and quick it can be. Other videos in the Virtualmin documentation go into more detail about how to perform other common functions. First, to create a website, you can click Create Virtual Server. It's the first option after the list of domains on the system. If there are no domains already on the system, there won't be a list of domains, obviously. That brings you to the Create Virtual Server form. At the top of the page, there's a list of buttons that choose the type of domain virtual server to create. Top-level server means a new account will be created along with a website and DNS zone. Subserver means a new website owned by an existing user will be created. Alias will create a simple website alias and DNS domain, making a new domain that points to an existing website. Alias with own email is just like the alias, only it allows you to create independent email accounts for this new domain. For our example, we just want a brand new top-level server. Let's call it blog.swelljoe.com. Description, which will be placed in the full name field in the password file, is used for a short description of what this website's about. Because this goes into the password file, you can't use some special characters and it shouldn't be extremely long. But in my case, I'm just going to say Joe's blog, and that should be fine. And I'm going to fill in an administrative password and that's all I'm going to change for this. There are a few other options down here, but usually if you've got your account plan set up correctly, and if you've got your server template set up correctly, everything's just going to work when you create your new servers. So I'm going to click that Create Server button now. And now Virtualmin goes and creates all the services for your new website. Specifically, it adds a user with the name and group blog, creates a home directory, sets up a mailbox, adds DNS, adds Apache configuration, creates a database, sets up log file rotation for the Apache error and access logs, sets up status monitoring, and a few other things. Notice here that it has created a Webmin user. This allows the website owner to log into Virtualmin and manage their own websites and applications. And now I'm going to take a brief detour to manually configure one item here for the sake of this demonstration. But in a real-world situation, if you wanted your domain owners to be able to use the feature I'm about to demonstrate, you would enable it in account plans for all new accounts rather than on an individual basis. And so to do what I'm about to do, you go to Administrative Options, and I'll choose to Edit Owner Limits. And in Allowed Capabilities and Features, I'm going to choose to allow this user to install scripts. This allows them access to the Install Scripts interface, which allows installation of blogs and wikis and content management systems, etc. I'll save that. And now for the rest of this demonstration, I'm actually going to switch to this user so that you can see what it looks like when you are a non-privileged user, a website owner user. Okay, so that I opened a new page. And you can see here that I've got a lot fewer options over in the left-hand menu, and I have a lot less information over here in the right information pane. Now, before we set up a web application, I want to briefly show you some of the things that a website owner can do by default with their website account. They can add users or edit existing users. And now these can be email users or they can be FTP access users, which are users that are allowed to upload and modify website content. They can edit and add email aliases. And Virtualmin sets up some default email aliases that are generally required for every domain. That includes abuse, hostmaster, postmaster, and webmaster. They could use the simple website editor to create a placeholder page using some of the built-in templates that we have, and use the WYSIWYG editor to customize it. This feature is only available in Virtualmin Professional. And if we granted them the ability, they could also manage databases, their DNS zones and records. All of these things are disabled by default because the goal for end users is usually simplicity. But Virtualmin provides lots of additional functionality that's just a configuration option away. Now there's a lot of other stuff hidden down in these menu categories down here. But for this video, we're just going to install the web application as promised at the beginning, and we'll call this video done. So to do that, I click on the Install Scripts option in the left-hand menu. This opens up a long list of available applications. In Virtualmin GPL, the list would be much shorter, as it only contains a handful of install scripts. Virtualmin Professional has over 100 easily installable applications. For this demo, we'll just install a blog. My favorite and the most popular blog software in the world is WordPress. And that's right here in the blog section. And we select it. And in this list, you'll see the name of the application, the version, and a brief description, as well as reviews from other Virtualmin users. And now we scroll down to the very bottom. Click Show Install Options button. And here, we could just accept all of the default configuration details and click Install Now if we really wanted to get started quick. But because this is just going to be a dedicated blog website and I don't need any other applications installed here, I'm going to choose to install directly under public HTML by selecting at top level in this install subdirectory under item. And if I had granted this user the ability to create their own databases, I would be able to choose to create a new database just for MySQL. But again, because this is just going to be a blog, it's okay that there's just one database called blog, and we're going to use that one. And now I click Install Now, and Virtualmin will warn us that we're installing this into the base directory of public HTML. So that if we were ever to delete this application, it would delete everything that's in that directory. Then I click Install Now. And what this does is Virtualmin goes out and downloads the latest version of WordPress that we know about, which is usually the latest version that's available. And then it installs it. It configures the PHP settings, sets up the database, does all the basic stuff, all the hard things for setting up a WordPress install. And then there will usually be some additional links down here that say, you know, what you need to do next. And so now I would click on that, and that opens up the WordPress installation, which is a super, super quick process. And so to finish my installation, I fill in a site title, give it a username. This will be the administrative user for the WordPress blog. And then there's a password that's already generated. I could fill in something else if I wanted to. And then I fill in an email address. And because this is just a test site, I'm not going to set it up to get indexed by search engines. And then I click Install WordPress. And it's done. And so now we could log in and start doing all of our stuff. And we can see that there is a complete WordPress blog now. Now, a cool thing about this is that we can see the state of our installed scripts on this server. If this were an old version that was installed, we would have a notice here saying that it was an older version and it would offer to upgrade it for us. We could also uninstall it. We can install additional scripts, of course. And this information is available to the root user or administrative user of the server as well. And so it's possible for the root user to keep an eye on all of the web servers that are on this system, or all the domains that are on this system, and make sure that they don't have old versions of WordPress or old versions of Drupal or whatever, as all of those, when they get old, security problems get found and they can become exploitable. All right, so that's it. In this video, we looked over the Virtualmin user interface a little bit. We created a new domain account, logged in as that new user, and performed a web application installation, all in a few minutes and without ever really seeing a command line or reading any documentation. So that's pretty cool. All right, thanks for watching. Be sure to check out the links below. There's tons of documentation for Virtualmin and Webmin, and there's an easy-to-use install script for Virtualmin that sets up the LAMP stack for you, and a whole lot more. And then there's some other videos on our channel covering other Virtualmin and web hosting topics.